Look like a fool. Really? Why are you acting like this? Play hard, tough football, earn respect. Because at the moment, I'm not saying you're losing. No, yes, you are. You are.
He's losing. He lost severely in the court of public opinion.
He's losing respect. Now, he can live with that. That's up to him. But he's a good person, Tom, but he's just acting really badly on the field. He's angry.
He has played great football without this being a part of his game. Mm. So the idea that Jack and Damien Hardwick are promoting as this is how he plays, that's nonsense. That's never been part of his makeup. This is the truculent Tigers since the resumption. So this is 14 fines and 6 in the past 3 weeks. It's impossible not to read that as anything other than premeditated.
His name's up there a bit, Tom Lynch, isn't it? T Lynch. Our boy Jackie's up there as well, 3 times. Yeah. Can I have a theory?
Yeah.
I think premiership teams and teams who win a lot of football, they start getting an air of arrogance about them. And then I remember when Matty Scarlett punched Hayden Ballantyne. Yeah.
There was a bit more history to
that. Yeah, I know that. I know that. But I think teams who succeed a lot think, who are you? Who are you? We've won premierships and you're mouthing off and you're doing this. And what they do, they get really frustrated and they hit them and hurt people, try and hurt people. So I think there's a level of exalted position here with some teams. Okay. It happens. That's only a theory.
Yep.
I may be wrong, but that's a lot of fines, Jared.
Yes. And the second fine for Lynch was a little bit of a shot across the bow. There is no longer any accumulation of fines that results in
suspensions. Do you want that?
It didn't actually serve its purpose particularly well the first time around. And this is why I'm not in the mandatory suspension. I'm all for trying to run this out of the game. But we lived through the era where the tummy tap resulted in suspension. And we as a football community, we couldn't hold the line. No matter how much we pretend we could, we couldn't hold the line. So I feel like we've lived through this before. But if Tom Lynch goes a whisker, there should be, Michael Christian should be looking at him now, and there should be no excusing him. If there is a reason to classify for a suspension, he should be hit with it, and then he can go and explain his actions before the tribunal. But what was done today was consistent.
What do you think of St. Collins after the game?
I didn't mind that he was carrying it. That's a guy who cares deeply.
Didn't mind
what had taken place.
Everyone loved this. Yeah. Everyone loved this. You know, people accuse others, including me, of carrying on sometimes. When a team loses and coaches get up and speak, fans want to see the frustration and anger out of the coach. But the coach can't do that in the post-match. We want them to say, he was pathetic, rah, 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 but they can't do that. To see a player exhibit the same frustration, the same anger, the same letdown in the post-match makes you really respect that person. Like, thanks for giving everything you had and still being angry after the game that you couldn't get it over the line. And the amount of people who tweeted, and he should be really proud, he's done it the hard way to get into AFL footy, Sam. And the amount, I don't know if he's on social media, but the amount of people who said, I wish he was at my club. Usually we say that about Franklin or Fife, or Martin. To say that about a defender with an attitude like that, I wish he was at my club. That's an enormous respect in the footy world.
He cares about his footy.
So well done.
All right, let's take a little trip around the country here, shall we?